have to discuss about the analysis of trusses, right? And the method of joint and method of section. But the problem is, today is the last hour to discuss the trusses, right? And I will wind up whatever we can do. So I am going to speed up a little bit, right? I am not going to solve the questions completely. Okay? I am just giving you some idea, okay? Because you know how to solve it, right? You know method of joint, method of section, is it? So nothing is new, right? So just going to revise a little bit about the method of joints first. So main discussion is about analysis of trusses and method of joints. And we are discussing about method of joints. The steps are, first we find the
reaction.
Find the support reactions. Then start from the joint at which number of unknowns are
two.
Okay. So this is find the support reaction. It is not necessary that every time you can do it. Okay. Right. Sometimes you can start even without finding the support reaction. Okay. Next is start from the point. Start from the joint at which the number of unknowns are 2. The number of unknowns are 2. So you need to select that joint at which the number of unknowns are
2.
Okay. Then draw free body diagram of joint by diagram of joint. Then what will be next? Apply condition of equilibrium and solve the joint. Apply condition of equilibrium and find unknowns. What will be next? Move to the next joint. Move to the next joint.
And repeat.
Yes. To the next joint. And repeat the same procedure. Repeat. Okay. Then, in this process, right, for the direction of forces, okay, so I am going to write, give you a hint, right, at each joint, consider the forces away from the joint. At each joint, consider forces are away from the joint. At each joint, consider the forces are away from the joint. Then, if answer is negative, then what do you have to do?
Change the direction.
No. If answer is negative or positive, do not change the direction. And keep on solving with the negative value. It is easy. Okay? If your answer is negative or positive, leave it. Okay? Then go to the next joint. Again, consider all the forces are away and use the negative values. Okay? Right? So do not change the direction. Okay? Then all the joints, do not change the direction if value is negative. Value is negative, okay? So these are like two very good hints, okay? So at the main, by this way, you can complete your question easily and you don't need to think a lot, okay? So the simple idea is at each joint, consider forces are away from the joint, okay? And if it is negative, forget about it. Take it negative, okay? Do not change the direction. Agreed? Okay, now, example. Exactly, I'm following these steps. I am interested to finish it very quickly, so that's why I am going to solve an example for which I have the solution. So suppose we have this dress, very simple one, just to give you an idea about these steps, right? And over here we are applying 15 kilonewton force, and this one is roller sport, this one is a beam sport. Here we are applying a 15 kilonewton force, and this distance is 5 meter. This distance is also 5 meters, is it?
Yes.
Okay. Then, when you will find the, and this point is A, B, and C, right? Let me say this is A, this is B, and this is C. Find the, complete the analysis of the truss. Okay.
So,
start from the.
Sorry?
Find support reaction. Please.
Yes.
No need.
Complete the analysis of. Then in the solution, right? First step is to complete the support reaction, but if you are sharp enough, so you can complete it even without finding the reaction, okay? You can start from this guy.
Yes.
How many unknowns are there?
Two unknowns.
Okay, so you can apply summation fx0, fy0, you will find these two forces. Then move to this guy. How many unknowns?
Two.
One. This one you have already found from here, right?
Yes.
This one is unknown and this reaction is unknown.
Yes.
So again two unknown. Okay. You can find this reaction, this one from here. So all these three will be known. Okay. But let's follow the simple procedure by following the by finding the reaction first. Yes.
That starts from point C.
Sorry?
Start from point C.
That's what I am telling you, that if you are intelligent enough, you are sharp enough, you have enough practice, then you can start from here. Okay? So you can start from here, right? Okay. So over here, this is 6 meter, and this one is 3 meter. Okay. Okay. Now what will be this angle, right? So this is 3. So this distance is also 3, is it?
Yes, 40.
So 3 and 3. So this angle will be
45 degrees.
When you will find the reaction, so this will be upward reaction. And this will be downward reaction. Then what will be this value? It will be 45 over 6, right? So it will be 45 over 6. So what will be this answer?
7.5.
And here this reaction is how much? 15 kilonewton. 7.5 and 7.5 downward.
Yes.
Can you find these reactions?
Yes. By moment, summation.
So just apply summation fx0. So 15 is equal to 15, right?
Yes.
Then summation of fy0, right? This reaction plus this reaction, there is no force in downward direction. Then take moment over here, right? Okay. Then over here, right? So what will be moment over here? 15 into 3 is equal to this reaction into 6. So 15 into 3 will be 45 divided by 6, you will get 7.5. Okay, so this is 7.5 upward, this will be downward. Okay, then now start from any joint. So let's start from A. So our first step is over, find the support reaction, find the angle, all the things. Okay, then start from the joint at which number of unknowns are 2. Then you can start from this one, this one, this one. From all, at each and every joint, the number of unknowns are
2.
Okay, now at joint A, right? This one. Now what you need to do, you need to consider the applied force, this one, right?
Sorry.
It's downward. It is
7.5
kilonewton. Over here, this force is in this direction.
AB.
This force is over here. This is your FAC. This is your
FAB.
FAB. And
45.
This is your 45 degrees.
Summation of.
So you can check that this one and this one, I am taking them away from the joint.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
So now, that will be your summation of
fx.
Fx equal to 0. This will give you FAB
plus
FAC
cosine 45.
Cosine of 45
equal to 0.
Equal to 0. Then, summation of Fy equal to 0, you will get 7.5 is equal to FAC
sine
of
45.
Okay? So from here, you can find FAC, right? And then, how many unknowns over here?
One.
FAC. So when you will find it, it will be how much?
1.6.
2?
10.
10.6, okay. So from here you will find FAC and it will be equal to 10.6 kilonewton, right? Then put this value FAC over here, right? So you will find FAB plus 10.6 cosine of 45 is equal to 0. So your FAB, it is negative, right?
Yes.
Minus 10.6 cosine of 45 minus 7.5, okay? So now you can see one is positive, other one is
negative.
I am not going to change anything. I am not changing anything, okay? Neither sign, neither direction. Finish, right? Class. After this one, I am going to move into which joint? So whatever is your answer, accept it, okay? Do not change anything, okay? Now after joint A, move to joint C. Clear? Now at joint C, what you will do?
You have one unknown.
Joint C. Again, you need to draw all the forces away from the joint, okay? Again, consider all the forces are away from the joint. This one and this one. What is this force? F?
CB.
We don't know this one. What is this one?
Timoise.
CA, right? CA. So what is the value of FCA?
10.6.
This is 10.6, right? So it is positive, right? Consider as it is. If it is negative, consider as it is, right? Do not change anything. Simple idea, right? At each joint, consider forces away from the joint and do not change anything. Direction, sign, do not change anything. Okay? It is easy. It is easy, right?
Yes.
So the easiest thing is do not change anything. Okay? So if you want to change, there is a way, right? But it will be difficult, okay? Right? So you need to think a lot.
Yes.
So over here, do not change anything.
Area 15.
So now over here, there is an applied force of 15 kilonewton. Now, summation of Fx equal to 0. How much it is?
Fac.
So Fx is 10.6, Fx equal to 0. Okay. 10.6. By the way, what will be this angle?
45.
So this one is 45. This angle is how much?
45.
So what will be this one? It is also 45. Because this will be 45, this is also 45, right?
Yes.
So both angles are 45. So 10.6
cosine of 45
is equal to 15.
Fine. Is equal to
15
plus
FCB cosine of 45. So two unknowns, we cannot solve it. Then take summation of FY equal to 0. So this will give you in y direction FCA sine of 45 plus FCB sine of 45 is equal to 0. FCA, we know its value, it is 10.6, right? So it is 10.6 sine of 45 plus FCB sine of 45 is equal to 0. So from here, one unknown, FCB. So you can find it. FCB will be equal to minus 10.6, okay?
We can little get FCB from the first equation.
FCB from...
Is there only one unknown?
Yes.
We can get it?
Yes.
FCB, summation of Fx equal to 0, right? Okay, fine. Because at this one, only one unknown is there, right?
Yes.
FCB,
yes.
Okay, fine. So, this is 10.6. So, we have the three forces, right? This one, this one, this one, we found out. So, it means we have solved the problem, okay? Now, what is force over here in AB?
AB
it is
7.5.
Minus 7.5. What is meaning of say minus?
Compression.
So minus is compression, right?
Yes.
So it means over here it is 7.5 compression, right? Okay. What about AC?
Positive.
AC positive.
10.6 positive, right?
Yes.
10.6 positive means
tension.
And CB?
Compression.
Minus 10.6. And it is again in
compression.
Okay.
Can you show the directions?
Yes, we can show the directions, right? So what is meaning of compression? If you want to show it with direction, right?
Yes.
So basically over here, If you are applying tensile force on the member, what will be internal forces? They will be in this direction, right? This is your tension. If you are applying compressive forces on a member, then the internal forces will be like this one, is it?
Yes.
Right? So wherever is, this is compression, right? It means this is the choice. Towards the joint over here, towards the joint over here. So this is 7.5. So over here, this is compression. Again, towards the joint and towards the joint. This is 10.6. This is tension away from the joint, and it is 10.6 also. Okay. So if you want to show with tension and compression, it is like this one. But it is exact, right? If you can understand this idea, right? So this is your member basically, right? This is your member. Are you applying tensile force, right? If I apply the tensile force, what will happen over here? It is moving in this direction towards the center, is it?
Yes.
So internal force in this member, it will be towards the
joint.
Towards the center. This is member. Right?
Oh, it's moving.
So and if this is the member, and you are applying the compressive force. This is the member, right? If you apply the compressive force, what will happen? I'm applying the compressive force, right? So what is happening over here? It is towards or away from the center line, center point, right? So over here it will be in this direction. Over here it will be in this direction, right? And over here it will be in exactly the same thing I have drawn over here. For compression, it is away from the center line. In tension, it is towards the center. Okay, but it's sometimes, right? It's not easy to guess, right? Okay, you need a lot of practice. So that's why we write the magnitude with the C and D.
Yes.
But this is also correct. Okay. Okay. So with this one, our discussion about method of joint is over, right? So method of joint is easy, and we can find all the forces. We can find the forces in all components, all members, right? Only you need to follow these two simple rules. If something is negative, consider negative. Do not change the sum. Okay. Next is method of section, right? Next, our topic is method of section. And one more example I can give you for the practice if you want. For example, we have this truss, right? It has two spokes, right? Okay, now this is also a pin spoke, this is also a pin spoke, right? Can you solve this one? If load is applied, for example, over here. Here we are applying 10 kilonewton force. Can you solve this one?
Yes.
How?
Start from the
left
side.
Over here, this one, right? All these distances are 2 meter, 2 meter, 2 meter, and this height is also, for example, 2 meter. Okay. Now, how you can start it? Start from this point. Okay. How many unknowns?
Two.
What will be forces?
Zero.
Zero, right? Because there is no force over here. No force is applied at this side, right? So, can you see on all these members, forces will be zero, 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 zero. Are you agreed?
Yes.
So basically your truss is only this one, which is resisting the load, is it?
Yes.
Right? Or you can, if you cannot understand,
apply
you start solving from here, okay?
You will get zero.
So everywhere this is zero, right? Because there is no load is applied, right? There is no load is applied. So if you take, if there is no load, there will be no force, okay? Again, you can solve this one, this is zero. These two will be zero. You move to this one, this is zero, this is zero, these two will be zero. You move to this one, then again zero. So all these members, they have zero forces. Only you need to analyze this one. Now at this side, one, two unknowns, okay? Solve this one. Then over, what will be force over here? Again it is
zero,
is it?
Yes.
What will be force over here? It is zero. Agreed? Maybe I get. Not say this one because
no.
This is one
reaction.
Is pin,
reaction.
Both are pin, okay?
Yes.
But this one is confirmed, right?
Yeah, zero member, yeah.
Zero member, right?
Mm.
Okay, so some type of interpolation is more important, right? Okay, then over here, in which part it will be tension? Can you guess? In which member it will be tension? I think over here it will be tension, right? This will be tension.
Yes.
Is it? Because you are applying force over here, here it is creating tension, right, on the top.
Mm.
What about this one? It is sure, at least in this one, these two will be compression. Okay? And remaining you can solve. Okay, because in the diagonal member, sometimes tension, sometimes compression. Agreed?
Okay.
So, next. Next is method of
sections.
Okay. So, by the way, what is condition of this truss? It is determinate or indeterminate?
Indeterminate. We have four reactions.
Yeah, it is externally indeterminate, but internally it is determinate. Internally means we can start and we will be able to find the member forces, okay? But externally it is indeterminate, okay? We have very less time, but still I want to explain this thing. What is B for this truss? Number of members.
Yes.
What is R? What
number
is
of
A, right?
G. Yes.
So, what do you think? If I find B plus R and 2J, what will be the difference between these two ones? They will be equal, less, smaller.
B is 15.
No, no. B is. I am just asking you without writing something over here. Can you guess what will be this thing? They will be equal, less, or greater, or
greater.
So your B plus R, it will be greater than
2G.
How much greater?
By 1.
1. Okay. Because all these are triangles, perfect, right? There is only one X reaction over here, so it will be greater than 1. Okay. So what is B for this member, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, right? B is?
15.
What about R? These are?
4.
What about J? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. J is 9. Now compare it, B plus R. 15 plus 4, right? 19, right? 2J is 2 into 9.
18
or 19?
18.
Okay, 18, right? So now you can clearly see 19 is greater than 18 by
1.
Which extra? One extra reaction is here. Clear?
Yeah.
Right? So this is B plus R is greater. So it is indeterminate to 1 degree. And when we see it over here, it is static. It is externally indeterminate. Okay? So, because this is only one, right? Okay, now next is method of section, right? In method of section, what you have to do, we pass a section, right, through the members at which we need the forces. Okay? So, in this method, is useful to find the internal forces in members in only few members of the truss. In only few members of the truss, right? What will be the steps? In steps. Here, usually it is important to find the spot reaction, okay? Find the spot reaction first. First step will be find the spot reactions. Then next is?
Cut the section.
You need to pass a section. Pass a section through the required members, okay? Means you need to pass a section from those members, right, at which you need the forces, right? And then apply, draw the free body diagram, draw the free body diagram left or right side. Agreed?
Yes.
So you need to draw the free body diagram of left side of the section or right side of the section, right? Then apply condition of equilibrium and apply conditions of equilibrium. What will be the meaning of condition of equilibrium over here?
Three equations.
Three equations, not two, right?
Yes.
Because now it is the whole system, right?
Yes.
Apply conditions of equilibrium. Means summation fx 0, summation fy 0, and summation of
moment.
Moment 0, right?
Yes.
To find the required force. By the way, anyone who can explain why we are applying 3, why not 2?
Because
in the trusses, usually we have the two conditions of equilibrium, summation fx0, summation fy0. Why here 3?
There will be more than 2.
Because
more
I cut the section, I cut the member.
Because in method of joint, the problem is, this is a concurrent force system. Okay? In method of joint, it is a concurrent force. Can you see? All the forces are passing through the one point. Okay. So if you consider submission of movement over there, zero to zero, no problem, right?
Yeah.
So for concurrent force system, we have two.
Yeah,
but when you pass the section, for example, over here, then this is no more concurrent force system. This is general force system in one plane, right?
Yes.
So you will have three things, right? Submission fx0, fy0, and movement at any point should be zero. Okay. Because this is a general force system in one plane. Okay. Okay. So next. But mind it, sometimes we combine the method of section and method of joint. Okay? Sometimes we combine method of section and method of joint. Some forces we find by using method of section, then in the immediately next one, we can find by applying method of joint. Is it?
Yes.
For example, over here, if you want to find force over here, right? In this member, so what you can do, you can pass one section, okay? Find this force. Then to find this force, no need to pass it again a section over here. Then solve this joint.
Is equal.
Right? So sometimes we combine method of section and method of joint side by side. Okay, now a quick example for the method of sections. And for practice, you have several problems in your book, right? And several solved examples. Now we have this is a little bit lengthy, but anyways, I am going to try it. So, where time will stop, I will stop the problem. Okay? But anyways, I am going to start it, right? For the method of section.
We have 10 minutes.
So, it means I need to finish it in 10 minutes, right?
Yes.
So, and after that, trust will be taken. Okay? So, we need to find the forces in two members. Truss is like that. So we have one member over here, one here. We have this member, this one, and this one. Okay. Now the forces are 0.75. This is 1.5 kilonewton. This will be 2.5 kilonewton. This is 1.2. This is 0.75. This is 0.75 kilonewton. Over here again, this one is 0.75 kilonewton. Here we have 1.5 kilonewton. This sport is pin sport, and next is roller sport. Here we have a pin sport. Here we have a roller sport. These distances are 2 meter, 2 meter, and 2 meter. All these are 2 meter. Okay? And the height of the truss is 30 degree. Height is not given, this angle is given, it is 30 degree. Okay. Now we need to find the forces. So this member is E. So this is point A. This is B, C, D, E, F, G, F. Now find the forces in member GF and CF. CF and
G.
Okay. Find the forces in member CF and CG. In this CF and CG, you need to find the forces. Okay. Then, what will be the spot reactions first? First, you need to find the spot reaction, okay? And you need to solve it by using method of section, okay?
Yes.
So here, use method of section, okay? Find the solution. The first step will be, you need to find the spot reaction, okay? So here, the reaction is upward. Here, we will have two reactions, right?
Yes.
One is this one. Other. Okay, so let's apply summation fx equal to 0. So what will be that? From here, what will be value of HA? Can you guess? What will be value of HA?
0.
It is 0, because
no.
This 1.5, 1.5, this is 0.75, 0.75.
Right.
All are symmetric, right?
Yes.
So this will clearly give you that horizontal adding is equal to
0.
Now let's apply summation of fy equal to 0. So this is horizontal at A, this is vertical at A, this is vertical at
E.
Okay. So next, summation of fy equal to 0. Now first we need to decide the angle, right? What will be this angle? For example, for this case, what will be this angle? So this is 30 degrees. What will be this angle?
30. No,
60. 60, right?
60.
So this 90, 30, 90. So this 30, right? Yes. So remaining is? 60 degrees, right? Yes. So for these forces, this angle is 60, right? So this is also 60 degrees, right? This is also 60 degrees. And this also 60 degrees, right? Okay. So now let's apply summation fy0, right? From in fy0, va plus?
Ve.
Ve. Equals to 2.5 plus this one and this one, 2 times, right?
Yes.
2 into 0.75,
sine.
What will be its component?
Sine of 60.
Yes. It will be sine or cosine?
Sine.
Sine.
Sine 60.
Sine 60.
What direction?
Cosine. Okay.
Sine.
So it is, this component will be its sine, okay?
Yes.
Plus 0.75 into sine of?
60.
So it is done. What about this one?
Let's
plus
2. 2.
2 into. Why 2? Because
it's
this one
same.
And this one, right?
Yes.
1 plus 1, 2. 2 into
1.5
into
sine of 6.
Sine of
6.
60, right? So you will solve it. So you will find the value of VA plus VC, okay? Then next, you can find summation of moment. And for example, okay.
Okay,
by the way, can you tell me what will be this value? VA plus VE, all are known, is it? VA plus V, you can find it. Okay? Then summation of moment at some point. Okay, at which point we can consider 0? Okay, at A or at E, 1 and same thing. Okay, let's consider at A equals to 0. And we will consider clockwise is equal to? Okay. Now at this point, how many forces will produce clockwise movement and how many are will produce counterclockwise movement?
Clockwise only 0.7.
All of them are clockwise.
All of them,
but VA is counterclockwise.
Only VE
counterclockwise.
Okay, first we need to decide the distance, right? If this is 2, right, what will be this distance and this distance? Can you tell me? Inclined distance, right? This is 2, right?
Yes.
Okay, this is vertical, okay?
Yes.
What will be this distance?
So
cosine of
EF.
Yes. Tan of 30.
So cosine 30.
Tan of 30 is equal to
EF, right? This EF, this
1.7.
Yeah.
It is
2 over
2 EF over DE. It is equal to
2.3.
Sine of
2 over
sine of, sorry, is that correct?
Yes.
So and DE is 2. So can you tell me what is EF? It is 2 times cosine of
1.7.
1.7?
Yes.
No. Start there because it will be more than 2.
2.3.
2.31. 2.31? Calculated? So 2.31, okay. So what is cosine of 30?
0.7.
So it is high particles over
0.86.
I guess you made some mistake over here. Is this correct?
2 over here.
No. This is 2 over here, right?
Yes.
Yes. Now it is correct. So now EF will be equal to this one and EF will be equal to 2.31. 2.31. Okay. So now EF is known. What will be DF? What will be DF?
2.31 sine.
Yes. 2.31 square is equal to 2 square.
Okay, so simple geometry, right?
Yes.
I need the value of DF.
Yes.
I need the value of CG, right? Both.
Yes.
DF 1.15.
Sorry?
1.15.
Which one?
DF.
DF is 1.15. Okay. And then CG will be? Is that correct? CG is 2.30. At least we knew all the distances, right?
Yes.
2.31.
Okay. Then what about EG? So EG will be equal to 4.662. So now we know all these distances. This distance is known, this is known. This one is known, this is known. All these distances are known, okay? So now let's take the moment at point E equal to A equal to 0. We are taking movement at point A equal to 0. Okay, what will be movement in the clockwise direction? Okay? So clockwise direction will be
1.5.
Sine 60. 1.5 into
sine 60.
No, I have this value of AH, right? Perpendicular distance, AH.
Yes. Yes.
I have this one, right? It is 2.31.
Yes.
Plus 2.5
into 4.
Into 4. Then
1.5.
Okay, now for 1.5, I need to change it into two components.
Yes.
Okay? So one will be this one, right? So the perpendicular will be plus
1.5 sine of 60.
Sine of 60 into
6.
6. Then for this one, it will be plus 0.75 into sine of 60
into 8.
Into 8, okay? So all these are producing the
clockwise
movement. Counterclockwise will be equal to VE into
8.
Plus
1.5.
So this one is done, this one is done, only this and this is left, right?
This will
and
pass.
This is also finished. So only this is left,
yes.
Right? So it will be 1.5
cosine of 60.
Cosine of 60.
And
what
two.
Is this height? This height is DF, right? It
yes.
is on 1.15. So now in all this one, only one unknown, VE, right? Okay. So what will be VE from this case? VE. And I think it will be 3.2. By the way, what was this answer?
This
is 6.4, right? So 6.4, this is 3.2. So what will be
VA? 3.2.
Therefore, VA it is equal to 3.2, also 3.2.
Yes.
So our calculations show that results are correct. Why? because this is symmetric case, right?
Yes.
So symmetric means whatever will be load over here, same will be over here. Is it?
Yes.
So 3.2 and 3.2. Okay, now any easy way to find these reactions?
I can sum them all up and divide by 2.
Yes. So sum up all these forces and then divide by 2. Sum up all those forces which are acting downward, okay? This 2.5 is this component, right? And divide by 2. Okay, so now we have found VA and VE. What is next? Now we need to find cross section over here. Because we need the force in CF, right? We need force in CF and CG. So this is the section which I can pass. Okay. So now draw this free body diagram of left side up, right side, which will be easy.
Right side.
So for right side, now considering right side. So over here we will have a 30 degree angle, right? So this reaction is 3.2 kilonewton. Here is one force. Here is another one, is it? Agreed? So what is this force? It is F. FFG, is
FFG.
It?
Yes.
FFG. This will be FFC. This will be FDC. Okay. And here is another force of 1.5 kilonewton. And here is another force of 0.75 kilonewton.
Take the moment at F.
So now, how to find the reaction? Take moment at point
F.
F. Yes. So this is point. D.
Yes.
This is point
E.
E. Okay. And F, FC is over here.
Yes.
Okay. Now,
take a moment at point C.
F.
So let's decide. Now over here, how to solve this joint now? Now we know the distance is right.
Yes.
So this distance is
2 meter.
This height is how much?
1.15.
So it is 1.15.
Yeah, 1.15.
And 2.31.
And this distance is
2.31.
So all distances are known, right?
Yes.
Okay, now in this one, let's apply summation Fx, Fy, 0, and we can find the required amount. By the way, which thing we want to find? It is FFC, right? We need to apply such type of equation so that we can find FFC, right?
Yes.
So if I take moment over here, right, what will happen? This FFG, it will pass through that one. This FDC will pass through that one, right?
Yes.
Only one unknown will be left.
Yes.
FFC, is it? Again, I need this force, FFC, right?
Yeah.
So if I take moment over here, FFG, it will pass through that point.
Yes.
So its moment will be zero. This moment will also be zero. So in that equation, we will have only one unknown.
Yes.
Okay, so we can quickly find it, right? So over here, let's find summation up. Moment at point E equals to 0. Okay. So now at this point, this is 0, this is 0, this is 0, this is 0.
1.5.
Only 1.5, right? So in this direction, this is how much it is?
1.5 into 2.0.
1.5 into
2.0. 2.31. FFC is
1.5. Now what about FFC?
The same.
Now what will be this angle? We need to decide about angle, right? Okay. So what will be this angle, right? This angle and this angle.
So they're not in the same direction?
Same
direction.
So this one is 2 meter, right?
Yes.
So this one will be how much? This is same, right? This will be angle
60.
Will be 30, right? So
yes.
This angle is 30, this will be 60, is it? With the vertical.
Yes.
Okay. So this is 30. What is this angle? This is 30. What is this angle? This is
90.
What is this angle? This is
60.
What is this angle? It is 60. Mind it is not 100, 90, okay?
Yes.
Okay, again. What is this angle? This is
30.
What will be this angle? It is
90.
So 30 and 90, so what should be this angle? It is
60.
Right? This is 30, this is 90, this will be So this is the only important point in this. Okay. So this angle is 60 degree with the vertical. Okay. So now what will be moment about point E from this one, right? So one will be this component in this direction,
and
another will be other component in this direction. Okay. So this component will be how much?
So it is 1.5,
and all are producing movement in the same direction. Right?
Yes.
Okay. So plus this component, right? FFC
into cosine of 60 into 2,
right? Plus FFC into
sine of 60.
Sine of 60 into
1.5.
This height, okay, it is 1.5. So
is equal to zero,
right?
Yes.
So you have only one unknown, FFC, right? You can find it from
minus.
So yes, yes. So FFC will be how much? If you solve, anyone who can
minus 1.5.
Minus 1.725, is it?
Yeah. Minus 1.507.
No. Any other one? FFC, right? FFC, right? So it will be, please be quick.
1.15.
So I have this answer equals to FFC is
1.736.
So whatever, you have minus 1.736 kilonewton. Okay, now, so FFC is 1, okay?
Yes.
So we need to find force in CF, right?
Yes.
How to find force in CG?
Take another section, right?
Yes. No, better is falling. Okay, if the force in CF, what will be force in CH?
The same
force, right?
Yes.
So this force and this force will be same, right? So
yes.
This force and this force will be same, right? What about this force?
The same.
This one will be same to this one, right?
No,
so first point this one,
yes.
So it then solve this joint. Okay, instead of passing the section, right?
Yes.
So now apply on this one, right? Summation Fx Fy0, find this force, right?
Yes.
FDC, right? And you can find FDC from summation Fx0, right?
Yes.
And Fy0. And then solve this section. Okay.
CG
so
will be 0, sir?
CG will be 0? Also, right? Because all those are equal, right?
Yes.
So this equal to this one, this equal to this one, so CG will be zero definitely. Okay, this will be your final check, okay? Okay, so that's all for stresses. Inshallah, I will complete it unless in the next class. I think only one or two are left, right? Okay, I remember all more. Okay, inshallah, attend us tomorrow, okay? And tomorrow we have lab. Okay.
Yes.
Right. And some of you have to submit the project, right? But the problem is, until now, no one discussed with me that we are doing this thing, or this one, right? So mind it. So if your work is of some level, right, then you will get the marks, right? Submission doesn't mean marks, right? Okay. If you want to get, for example, out of 10, you want to get 6-7 marks, you need to work hard. Okay. Just submission, maybe you will get 1-2 marks. Can you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.